Whether it's your social media or your bank account, getting hacked is equally stressful. So today I'm going to show you how to know if you've been hacked. I'll run you through the most frequent hacking schemes, how to know if you are a victim of hacking, and most importantly, what to do if you have been hacked. And if this video is useful to you, please consider subscribing to help us reach our goal. To understand if you got hacked, first, you need to understand how hackers get you. That way, even if you fix the consequences, the problem doesn't just reappear. But if you just need advice on what to do next, use the timestamp below to go to the solution. One of the most common type of computer attack that can affect you is actually phishing. A phishing attack actually begins with an email sent from someone pretending to be a reputable source. The email contains a link, but clicking it will take you to a fake website, where you could get infected with malware, get your credentials, or even payment details stolen. The worst part is that you won't even realize, hey, I got hacked, until the damage is already done. Mobile device attacks can be a bit similar, but they can happen on many different levels. You could run into an SMS hack with the attacker posing as a family member, friend, or colleague in need of urgent help, sometimes straight up monetary. Or they can also happen through network level or malicious apps. If just one password of yours gets stolen, password spraying could happen, also called a credential reuse. This hack was the cause of 80% of data breaches in 2020. It works like that. Let's say I was hacked once and now hackers know one of my passwords that they will try to apply to all my accounts. If I reuse passwords, more of my accounts get hacked. This is what makes it so important to have different passwords for each account. The next type of computer attack is called a drive-by attack. This hacking attack happens when you visit a website controlled by hackers. Usually, those are copies of popular websites like Facebook or Twitter. On any of the hacker-controlled websites, malware and trackers can be hidden within intrusive ad banners or even automatically downloaded on your device without your input at all. Any previous hacker attack could happen to you whether you are at home or traveling. But the eavesdropping attack is reserved to the cases of you using a public network. On account of most public Wi-Fi spots having low security, hackers can remotely access your device using an unprotected connection or even straight up steal your data as it travels online. You might have noticed that even when you are directly involved in the hack, there's no distinct signs of you being under a cyber attack. Unlike software invasions, account breaches are harder to recognize. Unless a hacker starts displaying suspicious activity on your account or straight up takes full control of it by changing a password, you might not even know something is going on. However, you can see if your data is breached using a special software. If your data is breached, it can only mean that someone might have your leaked info. This software is often called Data Breach Monitor. Google Chrome has it built in. It will look for exposed passwords of accounts you saved in your browser. But if you want to properly track your data breaches, I recommend using one of the well-known open source applications instead. Or you can even employ a dedicated paid solution. In fact, there are multiple VPN services that provide data breach monitoring as an extra feature. So let's say one day you get a data breach notification and, wait a second, I was hacked. What to do if you have been hacked? The first thing to do in that case is to hurry up. When you have been hacked, speed is key. So switch to third gear and get to checking your hacked accounts or accounts. If there are any social media accounts you can't access, notify your friends and family that you've been hacked. Also, contact the administration of the website to have the account temporarily blocked. If you can still access your hacked account, you should change your password and ensure that account is still attached to your email address. If possible, use the option to log out of all connected accounts. When creating a new password, make it complex. Reputable password managers can help in this case because they have built-in generators. If you're concerned that a hacker attack has caused malware, either use an antivirus software to detect and remove malware or just wipe your hard drive completely. Of course, if you believe that some of your actual documents or bank cards could have been stolen, you would need to reissue them as well. I know all this advice sounds like a real hassle to run through, thus are things you can do to make sure you won't have to deal with the consequences of hacking. First, create a different complex password for each of your accounts, or at least for accounts you are afraid to lose. These accounts should also have two-factor or multi-factor authentication enabled. When possible, try to have an authentication set with a special app or your mobile phone instead of an email address, since it can be compromised. Usually, I'd ask you to avoid public Wi-Fi, but it's often impossible. So instead, I'm going to recommend a way to make them more secure. When using a VPN, you can introduce encryption to otherwise unprotected connections. There are a couple of very good VPN providers you can use on all devices. I will leave exclusive links to them in the description. Next, disable automatic image loading in your mailbox, as they can contain trackers. And when it comes to emails, try to not click links in emails. Instead, access the mentioned websites manually. One more thing you can do is reduce your digital footprint. Don't use an account anymore, delete it completely. Disable cookies and cache collection and use a browser that doesn't keep your data, such as Brave browser. To summarize, there are a lot of nasty hacking attacks and dealing with their consequences is a huge hassle. So try to be mindful of the dangers and try to prevent hacks before they even happen. It's just easier that way. So how do I know if I got hacked? I hope I answered this question and helped you figure out what to do if your account is hacked. But if you have any more questions, don't hesitate to leave a comment. And if this video was helpful, subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and cool. See you soon.